إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: وما خلقت الجن والإنس إلا ليعبدون، ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون، إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in Surah Al-Dhariyat: And I did not create the jinn and mankind except to worship me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. Why? To worship Him alone. So does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need this worship from us? Immediately the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ. I don't want from them any provision, nor do I want them to feed me. So this worship to benefit ourselves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need us, doesn't need our wealth or our money or our power, our efforts, our ibadah. It is for us. Why? The next ayah, إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Indeed, it is Allah who is the provider, the firm possessor of the strength. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the free of need, doesn't need anything. الغني وله ما سكن في الليل والنهار وهو السميع العليم. And to him belongs that which reposes by night and by day, and he is the hearing, the knowing, subhanahu wa ta'ala. قل أغير الله أتخذ وليا فاطر السماوات والأرض وهو يطعم ولا يطعم، سبحانه وتعالى. Say, is it other than Allah I should take as a protector, creator of the heavens and the earth, while it is He who feeds and is not fed? We don't have anything. We don't own anything. Everything belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. Even the knowledge that we have, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah has extracted you from the wombs of your mothers, not knowing a thing. Not knowing a thing, even we don't know how to walk, or how to read, or how to write, how to eat. We don't know anything. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us everything. And He made for you hearing and vision and hearts, subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a great hadith, authentic hadith narrated by Abu Dharr radiyallahu ta'ala, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam calls his ibad, his slaves, 10 times calling them. 10 times he is calling us, informing us for our benefits. Hadith Qudsi The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ibadi. He starts with the statement, Ya ibadi. It is a call, nida. How many times? 10 times. O my slaves, or O my servants, I have forbidden oppression for myself and have made it forbidden amongst you. So don't oppress one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-Khaliq, the creator, the real owner of everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, حَرَّمْتُ الظُّلْمَ عَلَى نَفْسِي. O my slaves, O my servants, and of course, it is an honor for us. When we say, Abdullah, I am Abdullah, the slave and the servant of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is an honor. And that's why the best names, Abdullah and Abdurrahman. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, what are the best names? Abdullah, the slave of Allah. Abdurrahman, the slave of Rahman, subhanallah. The best knight for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah described him as Abd. Not a messenger, not a prophet. Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi. He did not say his messenger, his prophet. He said abdihi. He did not mention his name, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because it is an honor for us. It is haram, dhulm, oppression, haram, not allowed. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took this ruling for himself, from himself, not from us. Then he said it is haram to oppress one another. Ya ibadi, O my servant, all of you are astray except for those I have guided. So seek guidance of me and I shall guide you. Fastahduni ahdikum. That's why in every salah we are reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. We are calling Allah, invoke Allah, ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim, guide us to the straight path. Because the guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was giving da'wah to his uncle Abu Talib, he was calling him to Islam, to say La ilaha illallah. At the end he refused and he died as a non-Muslim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you cannot guide those you will or you love. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides them. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْ. The guidance, it is only in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala day and night the guidance. يَا عِبَادِي كُلُّكُمْ جَاءَ إِلَّا مَنْ أَطْعَمْتُهُ. Oh my servants, all of you are hungry except for those I have fed. So seek food of me and I shall feed you. We have a lot of food at home. We go to any restaurant and we order the food that we like. But we should bear in mind that everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The money that we have and we are buying the food, it is from Allah. Or if you have a farm, you have a lot of fruits and vegetables, it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تَحْرُثُونَ أَأَنْتُمْ تَزْرَعُونَهُ أم نحن الزارعون لو نشاء لجعلناه حطاما فظلتم تفكهون. Can you see the farm that you have? Who's doing the zira'ah? Who's making the plants to grow? It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Allah wills, can damage for you your farm, can make it black or yellow, dry. Everything is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ibadi, O my servants, all of you are naked except for those I have clothed. So seek clothing of me and I shall clothe you. We should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you put on your dress,
Alhamdulillah, you should thank Allah. All praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, الذي ألبسني هذا وكساني من غير حول مني ولا قوة. It is not from my power. It is not from my wealth. It is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O my servants, you sin by night and by day. تخطئون بالليل والنهار. سبحان الله. We commit the sins day and night. Every day, every night, every hour, every minute. Sins. From your eyes, from your ears, from your heart, from your limbs. Sins day and night. You sin by night and by day, and I forgive all sins. How? So seek forgiveness of me, and I shall forgive you. فاستغفروني أغفر لكم. أقول ما تسمعون واستغفر الله. الحمد لله وحده. والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده. أما بعد، إن الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the hadith, يا عبادي, you will not attain harming me so as to harm me, and will not attain benefiting me so as to benefit me. We cannot reach to that level, to harm our Lord or to benefit him. If you try to benefit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the benefit for you. I mean, when you worship Allah, you will not benefit your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. The reward will be for you. And when you do the sins, you cannot harm your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are harming only yourself. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servants, where the first of you and the last of you, the human of and the jinn of you, to be as pious as the most pious heart of any one man of you. Who's the most pious heart? The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyid al-awwalin wal-akhirin, the leader of all human beings and the jinn, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That would not increase my dominion in anything. O my servants, were the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you, to be as wicked as the most wicked heart of any man of you, maybe Fir'aun, if all people like Fir'aun, do you think that can we decrease the wealth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He said, that would not decrease my dominion in anything. Allahu Akbar. Nothing. Nothing can we do. Nothing can we do. I mean, we cannot harm our Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. If all the jinn, all the ins, what is the number of the ins? 7 billions? Not 7 billions. From the first human being, Adam, alayhi salam, until the last one, awwalukum wa akhirukum, subhanahu wa ta'ala. O my servants, where the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you, to rise up in one place and make a request of me, and were I to give everyone what he requested, that would not decrease what I have any more than a needle decreases the sea if put into it. What wishes that you have, what desires that you have, to have a big house, 2 cars, a palace, a garden. So if every single person of us and jinn requested from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala what he likes, what he desires, nothing can decrease the wealth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Except what you put. If you put the needle in the sea, then you take this needle out from the sea. How much this needle can decrease from the sea? Nothing. This is the wealth and the dominion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O my servants, it is but your deeds. It is but your deeds that I record for you and then recompense you for. So let him who finds good praise Allah, And let him who finds other that blame no one but himself. This is the main thing. Whatever you do, it is for yourself. I mean, whatever of good deeds, of getting the reward, it is only for you. Then you should thank Allah. At the day of judgment, when you get your book full of hasanat, you should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when you find in your book sayyi'at, sins, thefting, backbiting, missing the salah, فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ, you should blame yourself only. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the choice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you the power to come to the masjid and to recite Quran and to fast Ramadan. So this is one of the greatest hadith, brothers, sisters, the calls of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his servants. Allahumma aghfir al-mu'mineen al-mu'minat wal-muslimin al-muslimat al-ahya'i minhum al-ammat. إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم احفظ إخوان المسلمين في كل مكان. اللهم وحد المسلمين على الحق والتوحيد يا رب العالمين. اللهم ابعد عنا الشر وأهل الشر يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارفع عنا الغلاء والوباء يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفق ولاة أمورنا لما تحب وترضى يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ الشباب من المخدرات ومن المنكرات والمعاكسات يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.